Hello. This is an EI shot peening training instructional video. This video will show you how to use Dr. Kirk's 4 data point saturation curve solver for Microsoft's Excel. I will also go over how to enable the solver add-in and create your own macro version of the solver. We'll start by opening up the 2007 Curve Solver 1. The 2007 template works perfectly with today's versions of Excel, and EI supplies the files as templates to prevent users from saving over the original copy. You'll see that while we select an SCS-1 template, Excel will open up an SCS-11 spreadsheet. The SCS-1 spreadsheet is intended for solving saturation curves with only 4 data points. The spreadsheets have default values brought in from the template, with a solved intensity and saturation time. We need to put in our own data points as outlined in step 1. I'll add in the time values of 1, 2, 4, and 8. Take note, the spreadsheet's equations have difficulty with very large or very small values. You'll want to simplify your numbers. An example would be to enter arc heights in thousandths of an inch. Use 5.1 instead of 0.0051. As the other arc heights are entered in, you'll see the corrected points on the graph have been updated, but not the solution. To do so, we need to continue with the steps. Step 2 asks us to enter the largest arc height value into cell J4 as a start value. This is given to us in cell J6. I can just type it in. Or I can copy the value from cell J6, then paste the value into cell J4. Make sure you paste just the value. Alright. Now on to step 3, where we run the solver. Select cell H16, which contains the sum of residuals. Then run the solver add-in from the data tab. The solver add-in is usually located on the right end of the data tab. If it's not there, solver hasn't been enabled in your installation of Microsoft Excel. We can fix that. To enable solver, we go up to the file tab. Go down to the bottom of the screen that pops up. Then select options. This brings up another window with menu selections on the left side. Near the bottom you'll select add-ins. At the bottom of that screen, you'll find where we manage the add-ins. There are multiple options to choose from, but we only need to work with Excel's add-ins. So, we just need to click on Go. Put a checkmark in the box next to the solver add-in. Then hit OK. Now you should see that solver is available on the right side of the data tab. Great! Now, I'll make sure the cell with the sum of residuals is selected, and run the solver. When I do, the solver parameter window will pop up. All you do here is select the solve button. Keep all the default values on the next window, then click OK. When we scroll down, we'll see our curve is solved. It has an intensity of 6.9 and a saturation time of 2.2. Using all of the data points as reference, the curve is fitted nicely among them. Entering the required intensity range helps visualize the process. This is done in step 4 and is optional. As an example, I'll enter in the lower limit of 6A and an upper limit of 10. After the values are entered in, red lines will show you the acceptable range. Do you see anything missing? Solver does the hard job of searching the curve to find the one point where its y-axis value increases by 10% when its x-axis value is doubled. It doesn't label the intensity scale or time units. Now, you can print and save these results along with your process parameters. I recommend doing a save as with a name format that includes things like the part name, strip holder location, machine identifier number, and obviously the date and time of the test. This is just an exercise, so I'm going to exit the spreadsheet without saving. I'm going to open the SCS-1 template again, but this time I'll show you how to make it a little more user-friendly. We'll add a macro to take care of steps 2 and 3 for you, with a simple click of a button. For most people, the easiest way to begin would be using Excel search tool. After typing in the word macro, my version of Excel suggests, "U macros," as the best action. This is what I want, because it will list any stored macros. You'll notice there aren't any macros here, because it isn't a macro-enabled spreadsheet. Let's create one now. I'll type in anything as a name, and give it a real name in a moment. After clicking Create, you can see the contents of the macro. There's nothing here but the start, name, and end command lines. We'll highlight and delete everything, then replace it with text I've already prepared. This text file has two of my macros in it. We're going to copy just the portion for the SCS-1 curve solver. The other macro is for a different instructional video, so I'll highlight from here to there. Right-click, and select Copy. Then go back to the empty macro, and paste. You'll notice the macro now has the name of Run SCS-1 Solver, and will execute steps 2 and 3 when we use it. Before leaving the macro editor, we have one more thing to do. The macro doesn't know what to do with the solver command, so we need to make a reference for it. To do this, we go to the Tools menu. Select References. Put a check in the box next to Solver. Select OK. Then close the macro editor. I'll also close the text file, to get it out of the way. We can now run the macro. One way would be to go back up to the search bar, and select the recent action of View Macros. When Run SCS-1 Solver is highlighted, I could just click on the Run button, but there is an even better option, so I'll cancel. We'll make things even easier, by creating a button that will run the macro when clicked. To do this, we'll go to Insert. Select Text. Then Text Box. I'll make a large text box, and cover up the Step 2 and 3 instructions, since they are the steps the macro executes. I'll use the text, Run Solver. To make it stand out better, I'll make the text larger and bold. Center it from top to bottom. Then left to right. It still needs something. Changing the background color of the text box to red, and the text to yellow makes it stand out better. This looks good. Next, we make it a button. So I'll right-click on the edge of the text box. Select Assign Macro. Choose our macro. Then click OK. Now that we're done, we'll save it to use later in a special format. Go up to the File menu. And select Save As. I'll save mine in a special folder that I added to my desktop just for macro versions of the curve solver. Excel will save the file as a basic workbook, by default. But we'll save it as a macro-enabled file. Actually, the best option is to save it as a macro-enabled template. This makes it difficult to overwrite, as well as embedding the macro into the file. Notice that saving as a template causes Excel to change the save folder to its own template folder. So I have to reselect the special folder on my desktop. At this point, I want to give this template a unique name. I'll make it the same as EI's, but with macro version at the end. Here's our new file name. Let's try it out. I'll use the same data values we used earlier. The exposure times were 1, 2, 4, and 8. The arc heights were 5.1, 6.5, 7.4, and 7.9 thousandths of an inch. Like before, you'll notice the data points on the graph below have been updated. But the curve hasn't been solved yet, so we don't have a solution. Running the curve solver is much easier now. When I move the mouse cursor over the text box, it changes into a hand. This means the text box is now a button we can click. Watch this. Wasn't that quick? Here's the solution. Normally I'd save this file for documentation purposes, but this is a demonstration. So I'll just close the file without saving. This concludes this instructional video on the use of Dr. Kirk's SCS-1 saturation curve solver. We also have a video about using the SCS-3 version, which solves curves with 5 or more data points. Look for it online. If you need formal shot peening training and want to become certified in the process, or if you want to increase your knowledge and network with those in the industry, you should consider attending an EI shot peening training event, or schedule a private on-site training. visit shotpeeningtraining.com for more information.